What's up, guys? I'm Random Frank P, back with episode 204 of Room Tour Project, the series where we show off some of the best setups to give you some ideas and inspirations for your own setup. And yes, we've been doing that for well over 5 years now at this point. Pretty crazy. If you see anything you like, I'll have it all listed for you in the description down below so you can check it out. Let's just kick it off now, episode 204. First up, we have Basic Junglist with the cleanly mounted, stacked, ultra-wide monitors there. And last episode, someone was like, alright, we get it, you like the stacked orientation, stop showing them off. Guess what? We're starting off with one of those. Can't be tamed. So, he's rocking the Herman Miller M-Body chair there with the IKEA desk setup. And checking out both those monitors, the top one is an Acer 34-inch, and the bottom one is an Alienware 34-inch. Both 3440 by 1440p, with that bottom Alienware one is 120Hz. Like I said before, really clean mounting job, no cables in sight whatsoever for those monitors. A light strip behind the desk to give it some depth, and I like how he kind of has that top monitor outlined by those Nanoleaf Aurora light panels. Now into the gear and peripherals of speakers he has for audio mounted on both of the walls there facing him. It's the JBL LSR 305P Mark II speakers. And for the actual, you know, desktop peripherals, we have the Mashtop control keyboard with Halo True switches, a Logitech G900 Chaos Spectrum wireless mouse, which is used on a Razer Firefly mouse pad, and that's all sitting on a SteelSeries Quick extra extra large mouse pad. And as you know, over on the left side of the desk, he has his PC, which is the NZXT S340 Elite case. Inside here is an Intel i7-8080K CPU with a Corsair H100i AIO. Got 16 gigs of Corsair Vengeance RGB Pro RAM on an ASRock Z390 Tachi motherboard with an EVGA GTX 1080 Ti SC GPU. And then next to his setup for the more so entertainment console, he has a 55-inch TCL 4K TV with some console gaming, kicking back at night, watching Netflix from the bed there. You might have saw in the first photo for this submission, it was kind of tilted out, so he's got it on a bracket and stuff. But altogether, a really chill room. I like a lot of the, you know, the oranges mixed with the blue colors, makes it feel nice and cozy, and they're good complements to each other. Now we've got Giannis, and we've definitely showed him off probably like 2-3 years ago at this point with his custom desk PC looking really nice. He's now upgraded to 3 monitors, so we'll check it out for the 2020 rendition here. All 3 of those are actually a Samsung 28-inch, all lined up nicely as well. And I'll say it right now, because I know some of you are probably thinking it. Yes, it is a tad bit cluttered. There's a lot going on, so it's not like, you know, messy or anything like that. But that's just the, you know, the flow of the room here. You can see the hardware mounted on the wall. This is not meant to be, you know, minimal and stuff. He's obviously a gearhead, you know, a tech head, and that's definitely being shown. For the peripherals, we have a nice overhead shot here, giving us a sneak peek into the desk. It's got an MSI GK701 RGB keyboard on the Madcat's Rat 8 mouse. Not on the mat, you know what I mean. You know what I mean. And for audio, it's a pair of Shure SE215 IEM earbuds. Now, inside the custom desk PC, I always love seeing these. Obviously, lots of red RGB lighting going on. Tons of like these sponsor cutouts and stuff just to make them glow as well. It is a dual pretty much setup here, half of it being a PC and the other half a 16TB NAS, but he has an i7-7700K CPU with 16 gigs of G-Scale Trident Z RGB RAM on an MSI Z270 Gaming Pro Carbon motherboard with an NVIDIA GTX 1080 graphics card, and a lot of the hardware and the cooling components and stuff are from AlphaCool, but I just, yeah, like how can you not think this doesn't look cool? And since everything is well contained, it was a very neat build as well. You know the cable management's gonna be on point under the desk. You see just the light strip, no cables from all that hardware and stuff. So nice and clean under here. But yeah, I love seeing an update like this, you know, every now and then, just seeing how a setup has evolved over time. And I'll drop a link down below to his YouTube channel where he has an actual dedicated video on this if you wanna see it more in depth. But yeah, I'm digging it. Ooh, now we got Calpatica, and this one I probably should have or could have saved for one of those clean and minimal editions, just because, you know, it's all black and white, looking nice and sterile, and just, you know, it looks really good. And one thing you're probably going to see right away is that Quasar, like the Quasar Science RGB light tube that you see in background people's videos. Here he has one literally just under his desk, so
right off the bat, you know, this guy means business, plus the light strip behind the desk, really dig in the all white, you know? Plus, with that, it makes it easy to color coordinate. So if he wants, he could change up the color of the RGB lights, match it to a new colored wallpaper, and the setup is like brand new. So for these displays, the primary here is the Alienware 34-inch ultra-wide. The monitor on the left side is a 27-inch Acer, and he has the iPad Pro on the right, pretty much acting like a third display, or, you know, like a touch display and stuff, but it is mounted right there. For the peripherals, of course, he is going all white and wireless, just adding to that really clean and simple look. That keyboard is the AN Pro 2 with the Logitech G305 wireless mouse on a large white mouse pad. Don't really have the name of it. He just said he got it from Amazon. And those speakers are the Audio Engine A2 Plus with the Sony WH-1000XM noise canceling headphones. I bet you if they came in white, he'd have them. And then as we do over to the PC, this is the Fantex Enthu Evolve ATX case in the silver. Really liking how the white is just popping out here. Inside is an AMD Ryzen 7 2700X CPU with a Cryorig H7 CPU cooler. Got 32 gigs of Corsair Vengeance RGB Pro RAM on an MSI B450M mortar motherboard with an EVGA RTX 2080XC GPU. Calpatica, I am 100% on board. The black and white foam panels behind there to break it up a bit, the light strip behind the desk, above the foam panels even, under the desk. This is just a really nice looking setup. Next up, we have Lewis with another clean approach. Loving it. Great job on cable management right away. And as you can see, this just sticks out with those 3D geometric panels. Got a white board there with some backlighting so we can mount the monitors on that to, again, just clean up the appearance so there aren't any cables hanging down. And it's looking good. Even with the DIY desk, he kind of has this like a bit of a frosted acrylic underneath it, so it's kind of diffusing the RGB light, which in certain shots makes it look really, really cool. So both of those monitors are the same HP 24-inch display, obviously, so they line up nicely. Mounted on a bracket to those boards, cables routed behind it, and then down to the peripherals. I will be straight up with you. I have no idea why he has two of each here. Both of them are from iBuyPower, their keyboard and their mouse. So yeah, pretty confused. However, that's because he also does have an iBuyPower pre-built. This is their Element Pro. Still doesn't explain the two sets of peripherals, but as you saw, it's mounted above the setup inside an Intel i7-9700K CPU with the Corsair H60 AIO. Got 16 gigs of G-Skill Ripjaws RAM on an MSI Z390A Pro motherboard and an MSI RTX 2060 GPU. Going all blue on the inside, and I'm sure that shelf that it is mounted on is secured and anchored and cemented and any other word you could use for reinforced, because if that thing fell, that would be quite the hit to the noggin. But regardless, Lewis, a very nice setup. I think execution here is a 10 out of 10. I love the DIY you have going on here with those geometric back panels and the custom desk and that backboard. It all looks very, very clean. And then last but not least, we have Paul F, or Pulf, as I like to call him. He has a lot going on. It's very apparent there. Four monitors, plus an overhead, five total displays. Man. And as you can see, it's pretty much like a racing rig right there in the living room. So lots of stuff to go over. The three main displays, you know, the curved ones on the bottom, are a Dell 34-inch. And those are going to be the ones that's going to pretty much go along with the whole racing rig and the racing simulator he's got going on, because they span nicely and they're curved. It's appropriate. And then that overhead is a 65-inch 4K LG TV. It's one of their gaming panels, so it has G-Sync. So there, as you can see, if you want, you can do some gaming up there with that solo display. Leaving us with that last monitor next to the racing wheel, which is a 24-inch Dell touchscreen monitor. Pretty much gonna be acting like a interface, I don't know, touchscreen monitor. For the gear, we have an ROG Strix Flare RGB keyboard with the Razer Naga mouse. The chair for the racing sim is an Obudo Revolution with the SteelSeries Arctis 3 headphones. We've got the Logitech G29 driving force steering wheel, the Thrustmaster Warthog PC joystick, and that thing off to the left of his keyboard is a, what is it? The Contour Shuttle Pro V2. Commonly used for like video editing and stuff, but here you can add it to his rig. Man, a lot of my life is just reading gear. For the PC, which is over off to the floor on the right side, we have the Cosmos C700P case from Cooler Master. Inside is an AMD Threadripper 1950X cooled by an Enermax AIO. Got 96 gigs of G-Skill Trident Z RGB RAM on an Asus ROG Zenith Extreme motherboard with both an EVGA RTX 2080 Ti and a GTX Titan X GPU. This is quite the setup. A little bit overkill, you might say, but hey, for a racing rig and a dedicated, you know, just gaming spot, it's gonna get the job done, you know? And I'm sure racing here, playing some dirt rally or something would just be awesome. And this episode of Room Tour Project is brought to you by Corsair and the K95 RGB Platinum XT keyboard. This 2020 release is going to give us now a brand new wrist rest, all the same features you love from before, plus an integration with their Stream Deck software with those 6 macro keys, allowing you to do certain things while streaming and have all those commands tied together. If you want to check it out, I'll put a link for you in the description down below. All right, guys, that'll wrap it up for episode 204 of Room Tour Project. Hope you all enjoyed. Don't forget, if you saw anything you like, I'll have it all listed for you in the description down below, as well as some very simple instructions on how to submit your setup. If you want to be possibly considered being a future episode of Room Tour Project, just check the description down below for it all. But if you like this video, give it a big thumbs up to show your support. Feel free to follow me on Twitter at RandomFrankP. And last, if you haven't already, hit that subscribe button. I hope you all enjoyed. Have a good day.